Oh my, oh my. What is up, people? Hope you're all doing well. Welcome back to more Esports Talk as we are on the verge. Yes, as of today, guys, the battle for LA does begin. Somehow, it's still happening. We should all be grateful because if you guys cover this channel or actually watch this channel or other esports out there, so many esports events are being hit by the coronavirus, and luckily enough, LA will still be ongoing, at least as of me recording this as well. But also on top of that, as of last night, guys, some huge rumors sparking, which do seem to be very true. That's going to be Florida Mutineers after a top two placement just last event. Prestinni has now benched himself, Ferocities or Pharaoh to step in for him. This is exciting news on top of that because OpTic apparently also this week had interest in Pharaoh. That apparently did drop off as OpTic will stick it out. We'll talk about them in a second here. Prestinni, by the way, a now deleted tweet talking about his mental state, his current mental health, and how it's been apparently very, very down as of late. Now, with this, of course, the tweet on screen for all of you guys, it does beg the question, is this because the brothers are apart? What else is going on? How can you actually feel this way after a top two placement? You feel for the guy, and of course, his mental health, his health concerns have to come first before the team itself. And the team, I'm sure, is a part of this decision to actually bench him. If his mood is actually affecting the team as he says it is, then that does have to come first. He will be benching himself. Apparently, Pharaoh will get his first Call of Duty League start, and that's an exciting story. I talked about this when OpTic also apparently had interest in the kid. I mean, given his past, given what he admitted to in his past, and that was the reason why he actually did not get a starting spot in the first place, I am super excited to see how this kid does filling in for Prestinni. On top of that, it does, of course, beg the question, I will ask you guys, how long till the brothers are back together? And even further than that, of course, most importantly, when it comes time for this current starting roster, yes, it's going to be a tough event for Florida. Super, super tough opening matchups for this team. And that means, what if they do win? You know, does Pharaoh stay in? Prestinni stays on the bench? You know, one of your most notable players in terms of, I would say, face value. Or what if they do lose? Do you keep Pharaoh out even based off losses against tough matchups? This is going to be a very interesting weekend, guys. Of course, continue to break down news for all of you. Speaking of news that I fell behind on, it's going to be the CODcast. I will link it down below with Enable, who reveals so much in a single cast. I love the way that information just spills out of these pro players. They are willing to share just about anything you want to hear. I say it time and time again, we just don't see this in other esports. Let's start off with this guy. Speaking back on OpTic, I think it's Enable hinting at that JCap is next out if they do poorly this weekend.
Funny, bro, because it comes down to the team chemistry. I'm not kidding. Does. I could speak on this topic for hours.
Breaking down to a science, yeah.
Like, listen, when you team with someone like Austin, right? Mm-hmm. I actually really like Austin as a teammate, even though he is probably one of the worst teammates ever in the sense of trying to get his point across to other players. So like, I have thick skin, right? And like, he can bitch at me all day and I'll just go back at him, but like, I'll take his criticism because that's the type of person I am. But when you put Austin around players that can't do that, example A, Jay last year and Kenny got a lot better though. Kenny like really matured, and that's why I think he got a lot better as the year progressed. But Jay literally would just shut down. Like, if you put players around Austin who don't have thick skin and can take him bitching, because most of the time what he's saying is correct and it's for the better of the team. But when you have players that just shut down, they hate him. And Austin being Austin, which is like fine, that's just who he is, but Jay couldn't handle it. Literally 3 weeks into the game, Jay's like, I fucking hate this guy. Like, I'm not team with him. Like, I can't. And then I'm like talking to Jay on the side and Austin's talking to me. I'm like, yo, I'm never fucking team with fucking Jay ever. Like, this kid don't listen to me, bro. He just goes rogue.
Because we all know, and Enable actually reinforces the fact that, you know, not everyone gets along with Slasher. The way that he actually teaches and, of course, kind of critiques people out there, the way he gives criticism can only be taken by a few players out there, and Jay might be struggling with that. It's certainly, I think everyone can agree, if OpTic does poorly yet again this weekend for the third weekend in a row, changes will probably be forced because we've seen already other struggling teams making the same changes after just two poor performances. So everything rides in the line here for OpTic Gaming. Yes, Dashy has a sub change or a role change, I should say, as well. And we will see if OpTic can bounce back. And I hope they do, or we will see who is actually next out or what next big change comes for that roster. Also talking about other people who've already been changed out of their roster. If you guys are not keeping up with LAG or the LA Gorillas, they've already changed out three members for this weekend, Aches being one of them. The CODcast, they make sure to mention that apparently Aches is not only one of the higher paid players in the entire COD league, but maybe hint at the fact that it might be time for him to hang it all up.
But apparently since then, a lot has happened. No, they were not good.
Dude, you give Pat like a week or two, he's swindling himself back on that roster.
That's what I'm saying. So I have no clue. But I don't think it's that easy this time around. I don't think it's that easy.
I think this might, that might have been it.
I think we've said this before.
I know. I think the swindling, I think I might. Listen, Incado, master swindler, like, hey, sometimes you got to know when it's time's up. Like,
dude,
I don't know.
Could use another observer. I'm being honest, Pat, if you're in the chat. Like, could use another observer. You were really good.
I think I'll leave my two cents on that one for a bit of a later topic. I still do think we could be seeing Aches later on in the season, and a lot of that also depends how this LA Gorillas team does with such drastic changes heading into, again, not an easy event. We will see if these guys can actually perform, and if not, if Aches will actually start again this season, or, dare I say it, if he'll ever start again. I think he will, but there are plenty of people talking about maybe it's his time to actually retire from Call of Duty entirely. Very lastly, something you've probably already heard from the likes of guys like Tactical Rab out there. It was actually Enable, not himself saying, but of course Nameless and Pack hinting at the fact it could have been Octane who threatened to actually bench himself if Enable was not benched. Guys, there is so much drama and so many roster changes and roster moves this early on in the season. I don't think any of us saw it happening in this drastic of a fashion, but here's how they broke it down with Enable.
Bro, if we're boys, especially like some of the people on team, one chips together, like hit me up and be like, yo, you're not performing well, but I don't even care about that. You're not even putting that, like, you're not even putting in the effort. You know what I'm saying? Like, hit me on the side, like, yo, you gotta start grinding. Instead, it was just like, no, you're benched.
Can I?
That's insane, bro.
Wait, this how could a... it not be a team decision?
wait, rewind. All right, continue.
I'm not gonna throw names out there because I don't know.
The only person that anyone would just take blind like that is Sam.
Well, I don't know. So I like I said, I don't know with whatever I've been told is true or not, and I don't.
What have
really
you been
care.
Told? And then just say I don't know if it's the truth, but this is what I was told.
I've been told that it was mostly a two-person thing, and it was
a coach.
Let him talk.
I'm not getting into that. What I heard was if I wasn't benched for someone, then someone else on the team was gonna sit out themselves. And I don't know if that's true. I've heard that from people on the team.
Who even has that kind of pull?
Right?
It has to be Sam.
Fighting, bro.
So, but like I said, I don't know if it's true.
Sam said that to get you dropped after winning chips?
And there you guys have it. I hope you all enjoy your weekend. Of course, we'll be back here all day today breaking down other esports and gaming news. I'll be back here Monday to break down these results of the battle for LA. OpTic on the whim of changes. If they do poorly, probably going to see those changes. You know, LA, gigantic changes. We have a different Florida roster as well. Other teams have been experimenting with subs on the side with scrims, and if you're Atlanta or Dallas, you're probably laughing your way to the bank because it should be, or it could be, an easy playoffs, at least for those two teams. We will see which two teams compete in the grand finals this weekend for the battle for LA. Will one of the LA teams show up at their homestand? We will see, and I'll break it down for you guys hopefully sometime soon. As per usual, drink your coffee, drink your water, all right? Enjoy the rest of your days, be happy, smile a bit. Okay, bye.